doon sa dalawang affidavit ni Colonel Garma na nabasa mo at napakinggan mo. Yan ba ay pinapaniwalaan mo? Yes or no?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Niwala ka ba na mayroong reward system? Yes or no?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Okay.
Colonel Leonardo and then Colonel Garma.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Nakita ko yung second affidavit ni supplemental affidavit ni Colonel Garma. Colonel Garma, pwede niyo muna basahin itong second affidavit nyo para marinig po natin bago tayo magtanong. Kayo po ang nagpirma nito?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
So, ang date po nito is ngayon lang. October 22nd, 2024. Tama po ba?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Sino po ang notaryo? Attorney
Martinez.
Martinez. Tama po ba?
Okay.
Sige, Colonel Garma, baka pwede niyo basahin yung second affidavit niyo.
Mr. Chair, can I skip on the first, second, and third?
Yes.
I'll proceed with para five po.
Sige, okay.
I became aware of the so-called Davao Death Squad through various sources.
Pakilakas lang po, ma'am.
I became aware of the so-called Davao Death Squad through various sources during my assignment in Davao. It was a common knowledge among officers that almost all station commanders had special teams designated for specific operations. Although I did not know the identities of this team, a culture of silence prevailed among police officers in Davao regarding such matters. My understanding of this operation was further solidified during my tenure as station commander of Sasa and Santa Ana Police Station from 2012 to 2016. During this period, I witnessed the existence of a reward system. While I serve as a station commander of Sasa, I received a call from Lieutenant Colonel Padua, then the intelligence officer of Sir De La Rosa, who was the city director of Davao at that time. The call, which I received around 7 o'clock in the morning, informed me of an impending operation in my area of responsibility in Barangay Malagamot. From this communication, I understood the implication of the operation. A few hours later, I learned that a shooting incident had occurred in Malagamot involving a male suspect, which the investigation suggested was a legitimate operation. During my time as station commander of Sasa, the barangay captain, Barangay Hizon, reported to me that akyat-bahay incidents were prevalent in the area. They intercepted one male suspect acting as a spotter. An entrapment operation was planned, resulting in two suspects being caught in the act of stealing. One suspect was wounded and later died at the hospital while the other escaped. From that operation, I received 20,000 from Sergeant Suwan, which was provided by Boy Alce. Furthermore, during my tenure at the Sasa Police Station, a personality identified by the barangay captain Panakan as a drug pusher and user known for illegal gambling and being a nuisance in their barangay was killed near GT Gasoline Station in Panakan. I remember this person because in the morning of that day of his death, the duty desk officer informed me that he went to my office and left an image of the Holy Family. He told my men that he just went to mass and was very happy to present to our office the blessed image. The following day, I inquired with the police investigators about his death and the outcome of their investigation and was informed by Sergeant Suwan, trabaho yun, naka-care of po kay Nung Boy Alce. There was never any clearance from my office of this operation, nor was my office informed of it. While serving as station commander in Sasa, Santa Ana Police Station, I also became became personally acquainted with the aforementioned reward system from June 2014 to January of 2016. We conducted various police operations that resulted in the deaths of suspects, drugs pushers, and hardened criminals. In one particular incident, along the coastal area, we monitored the habitual akit bahay suspect. One suspect was caught in the act of climbing into another victim's house when my officers called out for him. He was shot during the ensuing confrontation, resulting in his death. For this operation, I received 20,000 from Sane Benventura. There was also an occasion when my office, in collaboration with CIDG 11, conceptualized a one-time big-time operation. This type of operation was outlined in a comprehensive operational plan and involved an interagency approach incorporating various government agencies, including the Commission on Human Rights, a Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency, and several PNP units such as the Maritime Unit, CIDG 11, Davao City Police Office, that includes station commanders, City Mobile Force, and the crime, the PNP Crime Laboratory, along with the local government unit of Davao for funding, barangay officials and media representatives as witnesses. The COPLAN was funded by the local government of Davao. Following the operation, a shooting incident occurred in self-defense, resulting in the death of a suspect. I did not receive any reward for this incident as my team did not engage in a direct encounter with the suspect. At the end of each month, all station commanders were required to submit reports documenting successful police operations to the LGU of Davao. These reports included details of case filed in the office of the prosecutor and other relevant information concerning the operation. For each case reported, an amount of 5,000 was allocated as reimbursement for operational expenses. These expenses encompassed bus money, meals, gasolines, and payment for agents. The disbursement of these funds occurred monthly through Irma Espina Akamuking, and we were required to sign documents acknowledging receipt of payment. For the death of suspect, Shani Benventura provided direct payments of 20,000 to station commanders with no signed documentation required. Numerous other incidents resulting in deaths within Davao City occurred, of which I remained unaware until after the investigations were completed. A prevailing culture of silence was instilled among all station commanders and city directors. Your Honors, Mr. Chair.
Salamat, Colonel Garma.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Yes, please proceed.
Maraming salamat, Madam Garma. I would like to direct my questions to Colonel Leonardo. Colonel Leonardo, totoo ba na ikaw na transfer from MPD to Region 11 Davao as chief ng CIDG ng July 2016, Colonel?
Correct, Mr. Chair.
Colonel, ano kaya ang dahilan? Bakit inassign ka doon at sino ang nag-assign sa iyo doon?
Mr. Chair, ang nag-assign po sa akin through memorandum orders, Mr. Chair, is Chief PNP Senator Bato de la Rosa, Mr. Chair.
Noong panahon na yon, sino po ang Chief PNP?
Si Chief PNP Bato de la Rosa, Mr. Chair.
Colonel, sa pagkakalam ko, hindi basta-basta na ma-assign ka bigla isang malayong assignment, kasi naman ng MPD, tapos nasa MPD ka, bigla kang nilagay sa Davao CIDG. Tama po tao, Colonel?
Tama po, Mr. Chair.
Paano maaari ibig mong sabihin na na-transfer ka doon, Mr. Colonel?
Meron pong order, Mr. Chair, direct from Chief National Headquarters, Mr. Chair, during that time.
Colonel Leonardo, mayroong nakasulat dito na true shoot order kapag gusto ka ng chief PNP, hindi ba? Ano po yung shoot order na yun?
Shoot order po, director po, hindi na dadaan ng usual process, Mr. Chair. Nangyayari po yun, Mr. Chair.
So, Colonel, ibig mo sabihin, malakas ka kay Chief PNP, Bato de la Rosa.
Maaari po, Mr. Chair.
Very close ka ba kay Chief PNP, Colonel?
Nagkasama po kami sa isang province at saka sa Davao City, Mr. Chair.
Marami po kasi nagsasabi sa PNP na ikaw ang pinakamalakas kay Chief PNP. Totoo ba to?
Ay, hindi naman po, Mr. Chair. Hindi lang po ako ang... Malapit po siguro, Mr. Chair. Yung...
Ngayon, ilang taon ka na-assign sa CIDG 11?
4 years po ako doon, Mr. Chair.
4 years, Colonel? Diba, dapat may clean na yung 1 year or 2 years. Pag sa kakalam ko, hindi po pwedeng papalitan. Bakit more than 2 years yata yung pag-stay natin sa CIDG 11? Colonel?
Basta hindi lang po ako nare-relieve, Mr. Chair. Naghihintay po ako kung i-relieve po ako, Mr. Chair. Hindi po ako nakatanggap ng order.
Hindi ka nakatanggap ng order para palitan ka na kahit naging 4 years ka na doon, Colonel?
Opo, Mr. Chair.
Colonel Leonardo, ngayon, di ba nagpatunay ito ng naiba? Kasi matagal kang na-assign dyan sa CIDG 11. Ano ba ang dahilan? Bakit hindi ka po napapalitan?
Nung time po na yun, hindi po ako napapalitan, Mr. Chair.
Pakiulit po.
Basta hindi po ako napapalitan kasi wala po akong nare-receive na order, Mr. Chair.
Yun nga eh, Colonel, yun ang ibig kong sabihin. Kasi walang chief PNP na gustong mag-alis sa'yo dyan kasi malakas ka sa presidente, former president. At kay Senator Bongo. Tama ho ba yun na Colonel Leonardo?
Malapit din po ako, Mr. Sir, sa kanila.
Malapit ka kay? Pakiulit po.
Malapit po ako sa kanila po yung...
Kanino po? Pakibanggit po kung kanino.
Ngayon Senator Bongo po, Mr. Chair.
At kay Presidente?
Maaaring ganun din po, Mr. Chair.
Maaari ba, Colonel? Bakit, ano ba ang ginagawa mo para sa kanila? Bakit napakalapit mo sa ating Pangulo at kay Senator Bongo?
Unang-una, Mr. Chair, si Senator Bongo po, na minsan na nautusan din po ako nung time na yun, Mr. Chair. Kung ano po ang kailangan nila, kung kaya ko po, at concerning yung pong function ko as a CIDG Regional Chief, Mr. Chair.
Pwede mo akong kaming bigyan ng halimbawa na inuutos sa iyo ni dating Pangulo at paano ka nagre-report or vice versa? Paano ka binibigyan ng instructions? Tinatawagan ka ba? Tinitext ka ba? Ini-email ka ba? Paano po, Colonel?
Tinatawagan po ako ni Senator Bongo noon po. Pagka meron lang po mga ipapacheck, meron siyang kailangan information or sometimes meron kailangan i-verify or kung ano man po ang inuutos niya, Mr. Chair.
Ngayon, ang ibig ko pong sabihin, ang ibig kong sabihin ay nakakadirekta kang tumawag anytime kay Senator Bongo. Tama ho ba?
Pag may utos po, Mr. Chair, nakakadirekta naman po.
Nakakadirekta po kayo. So, ano namang klaseng mga utos, Colonel? Pwede ka bang magbigay ng halimbawa gaya ng ano? Na halimbawa may utos sa'yo, Colonel, pwede bang ganito? Pwede mo akong bigyan ng halimbawa dito sa committee ito?
Halimbawa po, may kailangan siya na information at kaya ko naman pong ibigay. Ibibigay ko po sa kanya. At kung wala akong information, magtatanong po ako doon sa kung saan po yung concern ng kanyang itinatanong or kung ano man po ang gusto niyang malaman, Mr. Chair.
Anong halimbawa itatanong niya? Tatanong niya kung anong bayan yan, kung sinong tao yan, o halimbawa kung anong lugar yan. Yun ho ba tinatanong sa inyo?
Meron din pong ganoon, Mr. Chair.
So, kadalasan, yun po ang ginagawa nyo?
Opo, Mr. Chair.
So, ikaw ang nagbabalidate o nagbibigay ng impormasyon na kailangan niya tungkol sa isang tao. Tao, lugar, ganun ba ang ibig nating sabihin dito? At siyempre, kailangan mo ring i-validate ang isang bagay kung ano ang pwedeng may report mo sa ating boss. Tama ho ba, Colonel Leonardo?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Anong pagkakataon na natatandaan mo yung binalidate mo kay Senator?
May mga incident po na tinatanong niya kung halimbawa may insidente po silang dumating na report sa kanila. Tapos yung insidente po na yun ay gusto niyang i-validate. Ako naman po ang gagawin ko, minsan tatawag po ako sa mga region na concern po yung information. Then ipapasa ko po sa kanya, Mr. Chair.
So meaning to say, tinatanungan ka about sa mga nangyayari, sa mga tao na halimbawa may namamatay o nahuhuli during the time, Colonel, tama ho ba?
Meron din po mga ganong pagkakataon, Mr. Chair, pero bibira lang po.
So, ibig mo sabihin na pag may nangyari sa isang lugar, ikaw ang tatawag at i-report mo. Ibabalidate mo sa kanya ang nangyayari, Colonel? Ganyan ba?
Halos ganun po. Mag-check po ako sa isang kung saan po yung...
Pwede pag-iulit, medyo mahina ang boses nyo?
Ganun nga po, Mr. Chair.
Colonel Leonardo, totoo ba yung naririnig ko na kayo ang paymaster?
Hindi naman po, Mr. Chair.
Sino po ang alam niyong paymaster pag halimbawang may na-validate, may nangyari sa aking research, parang ikaw ang kilala mo ba kung sino yung nagbabayad?
Wala po akong personal knowledge, Mr. Chair, kung tungkol sa kung anong itinutukoy niya na magbabayad, Mr. Chair.
So, Colonel Leonardo, gusto ko lang idiin ang tanong kay Colonel Leonardo at malinaw na inaamin niya ang nagre-report siya kay Senator Bongo at si Senator Bongo naman ay nagre-report kay President Duterte. So, ibig lang sabihin, malinaw, ang plano na kaya dinala si Colonel Leonardo sa CIDG 11 ay para pakinabangan nila sa pagbibigay ng impormasyon o taga-validate ng mga impormasyon tungkol sa mga nangyayari noong implementasyon ng War on Drugs ng past administration ng Duterte administration. Tama ho ba, Colonel Leonardo?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Pakiulit po. Tama ho ba?
Yes po, Mr. Chair.
Ngayon, ang last question ko po sa iyo, Colonel Leonardo. Nabasa mo itong first affidavit ni Colonel Rowena Karma. At binasa niya ngayon yung pangalawang supplemental agreement. Supplemental affidavit ni Colonel Garma. May tanong po ako sa inyo. Naniniwala po kayo sa dalawang affidavit ni Colonel Garma at pinatotoo niyo pa na itong lahat sinasabi ni Colonel Garma ay wala kasinungalingan at totoo itong sinasabi niya? Microphone, please.
Opo, Mr. Chair. Ito pong paragraph 14 po, Mr. Chair.
So, pinatotohanan mo lahat itong dalawang first affidavit and supplemental affidavit of Colonel Rowena Garma. So I just want to put on record, Mr. Chairman, that these two affidavits are validated by
Mr. Chairman, who is that person that is whispering to Colonel?
May I know?
What is the personality of that person?
Is he your lawyer, Colonel Leonardo?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
What is his name?
Attorney Aguinaldo Sepnio, Mr. Chair.
Attorney, have you entered your appearance before this committee? Already, in the past. You did not change your lawyer. What about the gentleman beside you, attorney? Are you also the lawyer? You belong to the same law firm, I suppose. May I know what's your name, attorney?
Good evening, Your Honors. My name is Attorney Andres P. Manuel Jr.
Attorney Andres?
Yes, po.
And did Colonel Leonardo engage your services?
Yes, Your Honor.
Is that correct, Colonel Leonardo?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
So you have two lawyers with you?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Okay, sige, salamat. Please continue.
So, yun lang yung aking huling katadungan na yung dalawang affidavit, pinatotoo lang, that the two affidavit of Colonel Garma are correct. Tama po lahat ito. Maraming salamat po, Mr. Chairman.
Okay, thank you.
Mr. Chair.
Before, are you going to interpolate Congressman Abante?
Yes.
Okay, Congressman Abante, and then Congressman Rog Gutierrez, and then Congressman Lord Ansuan. Please proceed, Congressman Abante.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Colonel Leonardo, I just would like to make a premise of my argument to you, no? Kung maaari ka lang makinig, di ba? Narinig mo na ang ipinahayag ni Colonel Garma tungkol sa kanyang dalawang affidavit. Hindi ko na kinakailangan pang yan ay bigyan ng kaukulang pansin pa. Subalit, for the purpose of clarification, Mr. Chair, Colonel Leonardo, I just would like to make this manifestation before I would ask you a question. Sa wikang Tagalog, ito po ang sinasabi. Ayon sa testimony ni Colonel Garma, sinabi daw ni Presidente Duterte sa kanya na kailangan niya na isang PNP officer or operative who is a member of the Iglesia ni Cristo, indicating that he needed someone of implementing the war on drugs on a national level, replicating the Davao model. Ang sabi niya, ikaw ay nakasama sa meeting na yan. Itong meeting na ito ay preparatory para sa war on drugs ni Pangulong Duterte. I would like you to know that me personally believe that drugs should not in any way be permeating in this nation. Palagay ko, naniniwala ka rin dyan, di ba? Naniniwala po ako dyan. I believe in the war on drugs. But what I do not believe is when you have to kill more than 20,000 people so that drugs can be stopped. And it did not even stop. Palagay ko, you being a religious person, Colonel Leonardo, naniniwala din po kayo na ayaw nyo ng maraming mga killings. Ano po? Oo. Yan din ang paniwala nyo, di ba? Alright. Ngayon, ito ang sinabi ng ating Pangulo. I-quote ko, ha. Hitler massacred 3 million Jews. That is his quotation at one time. Eh, mali pa nga yung 3 million eh. It is 6 million. Hitler massacred 6 million Jews, as I correct it. At ang sabi niya, there is 3 million drug addicts in the Philippines. There are. I'd be happy to slaughter them. Palagay ko naman, ay hindi ka naniniwala dito sa sinabi ng ating Pangulo na ayaw ko naman na matawag siya na siya ang Hitler ng Pilipinas. Baka sabagat binanggit niya to eh. Am I right? O ito po. Ito na po ang question ko, and this will only be answerable yes or no. I am not going to ask any more explanation, Colonel Leonardo. Sagutin niyo lang ako ng yes or no. Doon sa dalawang affidavit ni Colonel Garma na nabasa mo at napakinggan mo, yan ba ay pinapaniwalaan mo? Yes or no?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Pangalawang tanong, also answered by yes or no. Naniniwala ka ba na merong reward system? Yes or no?
May narinig ako, yes, Mr. Chair.
No. Yes or no lang. Naniniwala ka ba na merong reward system? Yes or no?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Yun lang po ang gusto ko. I rest my case, Mr. Chairman. Sinagot na po ni Colonel Leonardo ang aking mahalagang katanungan. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Congressman Abante. The next interpolator is Congressman Rog Gutierrez. You are recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Mr. Chair, konting katanungan lang po kay Colonel Leonardo. Colonel Leonardo, good evening po, Mr. Chair. Alam ko po, some of these questions were already asked earlier, but given the context of the new affidavit of Ms. Garma, we thought we'd ask you again po, no? So, Colonel Leonardo, can you tell us again, I believe this was asked by Chairman Dan Fernandez earlier. According to the affidavit of Colonel Garma, kayo po ay tinap ng former president to form a special team, no, to replicate the Davao template. Do you confirm this, Mr. Chair?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
But according to your statement earlier, contrary to the affidavit of Colonel Garma, hindi po ito natuloy.
Hindi po natuloy, Mr. Chair.
Hindi po natuloy. So, in a sense, you admit that there is a Davao template po ba?
Meron po, Mr. Chair, yung tokhang, Mr. Chair.
Okay. So, tokhang, meron pong Davao template, and you were tasked with replicating it nationwide. Nabanggit po ninyo na yung original tasking for, supposedly yung task force, is to replicate it Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao. Tama po ba ito?
Initially po, nag-plano nga pong ganun, Mr. Chair, yung sa task force, na hindi naman po natuloy, Mr. Chair.
Hindi natuloy kasi na-operationalize yung drug war through Operation Double Barrel, Upland Double Barrel. Tama po ba?
Tama po, Mr. Chair.
But despite the existence of Upland Double Barrel, nag-continue pa rin po ba yung inyong task force in some other capacity?
Hindi na po, Mr. Chair, nag-follow po kami kung ano yung national implementation yung nung double barrel, Mr. Chair.
So you are now operating within the terms of upland double barrel. But after that po, no, kasi naalala po natin, nabanggit po sa affidavit ni Colonel Garma, yung meeting po ninyo, which you did not deny, between class 96 and 97, nangyari sometime in May 2016, just before, after the victory of the incoming administration, but before taking oath noong June 30, tama po ba?
Last week po ng June, Mr. Chair.
Last week of June pala, sorry. So the last week of June, but before assumption po ng administration.
Yes po, Mr. Chair.
Ang nabanggit po sa affidavit ni Colonel Garma na meron po kayo sa nang you were already tapped for this task force. May nabanggit na po sana ng operational ideas kayo. But after the meeting noong June 2016, may mga pagbabago. Ito na po ba yung sinabi mong hindi natuloy or more on mga operational changes lang po ito?
Yan na po yun, Mr. Chair. Hindi na po yun natuloy.
Hindi natuloy. But despite that, Mr. Chair, Colonel Leonardo, shortly after, 1 week after assumption of office of the new administration, nalipat na po kayo sa CIDG 11. Tama po ba?
Tama po, Mr. Chair.
So kayo po ay naging regional chief for CIDG.
Tama po, Mr. Chair.
And I believe natanong na po ito dati, pero as CIDG chief, you would only report to either the chief PNP or the regional director. Tama po ba?
Okay, ulit po, Mr. Chair, na medyo ako.
As chief ng regional CIDG, you would only report to one, your chief PNP, and two, yung regional director po ninyo. Tama po ba?
Tama po, Mr. Chair.
But aside from this, you still have admitted before that you have a personal relation with both with the former president. Tama po ba?
Personally, magkakilala po kami, Mr. Chair.
But of course, tinap na po kayo for the supposed task force. Kahit hindi natuloy, nagkaroon po kayo ng meeting sa Mandalay Hotel po ba yun?
Panakan po, Mr. Chair.
I'm sorry.
Panakan po. Panakan, Davao City, Mr. Chair.
Apo, so nagka-meeting po kayo. So you're in a familiar terms with the former president?
Nagkaroon po kami ng, na-meet lang namin siya, Mr. Chair. Dahil courtesy call po yun, Mr. Chair.
Courtesy call, but you admitted earlier that you were tapped for the task force. Kahit hindi natuloy, na-tap po kayo ng administration. Tama po ba?
Apo, Mr. Chair.
Okay, so given that you were tapped, and then given that you had that meeting, despite po na hindi na operationalize yung iyong task force, you already had that working relationship while you were chief of CIDG 11. Tama po ba?
Tama po, Mr. Chair.
So given that you were already, although again, you were tapped, hindi nag-operationalize yung task force, but since you have that personal relation, would at times the president contact you during your stint as CIDG 11 chief?
Hindi po si former president kumakontak sa akin, Mr. Chair, pag may kailangan sila. Sap Bongo, Mr. Chair.
So si Special Assistant to the President Bongo yung nagko-contact po sa inyo?
Opo, Mr. Chair, pagka may kailangan lang po.
And aside from Sap Bongo, as you mentioned earlier, si Chief PNP Bato de la Rosa would also contact you. Tama po ba? Or for any concerns of the president, talagang kay Sap Bongo lang po yan?
Sap Bongo lang po, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Just to clarify also, kapag may concerns yung presidente, minsan dumadaan po ba ito sa regional chief ninyo sa PNP? Or talagang...
Minsan po akong tinatawagan, Mr. Chair.
Minsan po tinatawagan. Pero if the president would not course any instructions to the chief PNP, it's unlikely that the president will course instructions through your regional chief. And what you've admitted just now po, Colonel Leonardo, is that usually through Sap Bongo po yung mga instructions. Now, Mr. Chair, most respectfully, Colonel Leonardo, what kind of instructions po ang dinadaan po through Sap Bongo?
Kung mayroon lang po siyang gustong itanong, malaman na mga information, Mr. Chair, minsan po ako po ang nautusan, nanghingi ng information sa akin, Mr. Chair.
And yung information po na hiningi nila, this is purely confined to Region 11 matters, that would concern the CIDG 11. Is that correct?
Usually, tungkol sa Region 11 po, Mr.
Usually, pero would they ask you concerns, let's say, regarding Luzon, regarding Visayas, or other regions of Mindanao?
Meron din po, pero bihira lang po, Mr. Chair.
Bakit kaya po tinatanong, why would they be asking you if you are CIDG 11 chief, but they would ask you for information other places? Would this somehow be related with the fact na kayo nga po ang tinap for the operationalization of the drug war task force?
Hindi naman po, Mr. Chair. Actually, they can go straight through to the chief PNP, Mr. Chair. But there are instances, Mr. Chair, na kung kaya naman sa level ko lang po, minsan ako na po nakautusan just to check, Mr. Chair. Or just to give them information. Kung ano po yung inuutos, Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair, in your experience po, in your many years in the PNP, is it normal for the President to contact a regional head? Isn't it usually for any concerns that they would have sa chief PNP po tinatanong?
It's not the President who's contacting me, Mr. Chair. It was only then Sap Bongo, Mr. Chair.
Sorry, just to clarify, Colonel Leonardo, but you mentioned that Sap Bongo would contact you on behalf of the President. Or you have no way to confirm?
I believe, Mr. Chair, may direct contact po sa kay President, Mr. Chair.
Opo. So it would be understandable kasi po siya ay special assistant to the President. So any concerns coming from him would naturally flow from Malacanang. So you would assume that is from the President. So forgive me for the semantics when I mentioned earlier that the President would contact you, but to be technically, to be specific, as you said, so it would be Sap Bongo who would contact you for concerns that may involve the President. Tama po ba?
For concerns that he wanted to know about, Mr. Chair.
Okay. And generally, Colonel Leonardo, through the Chair, most respectfully, these are drug war-related concerns?
Meron din pong mga information na gano'n, Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair, just to clarify po, no? Kasi nabanggit nga rin naman ni Chair Bante. So you believe that there is a payment and reward scheme. Tama po ba?
Naririnig ko lang po, Mr. Chair.
Naririnig mo. Have there been any instances when you have been contacted by the leaders? In this case, sabi niyo po, si Sap Bongo, did he ask you to verify anything in relation to either the drug list or a payment of reward scheme?
Mayroon pong tinatanong sa akin na information about yung mga nasa list. Ako naman po, tatanong po ako sa PNP, Mr. Chair. Pero sa doon po sa reward, hindi po ako natanong tungkol doon, Mr. Chair.
Nabanggit po earlier, I think it was Congressman Pimentel who was asking you about a certain list of names that were mentioned in the affidavit of Ms. Garma. Nabanggit po dito yung the likes of Romel Baktat, Rodel Serbo, Michael Palma, Lester Bergaño, and Peter Parungo. And you confirmed knowing them, tama po ba, Mr.
Yes,
Chair?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
But you deny that this was the team that you tapped even for your temporary task force? Or do you admit na sila nga po ang kinontak ninyo?
Actually, they were part of the plan, but it did not happen, Mr. Chair.
Okay, so they were part of the plan. And when...
Yes, Mr. Yes. Chair. Some of them, not all of them, because the other two are just striker, Mr. Chair.
Strikers.
Civilian.
And you admit to having contacted them because they were part of the plan in which you were going to know. So this corroborates the affidavit of Ms. Garma. However, you deny that this was operationalized. You mentioned that upon the assumption of the administration and the operationalization of Oplan Tokhang, hindi po ito natuloy. But how do we account for the fact that Ms. Garma was able to identify them po? Did you at any time inform Ms. Garma of these so-called picks of yours for your team?
I confirm that I actually invited her to join the proposed team, Mr. Chair, but she declined.
Okay, so when you invited her for the proposed team, that's the time that you mentioned to Colonel Garma na ito po ang mga pinili ko nyo for the team and then ganito yung magiging operational protocol po niyo, etc., etc. Is that a one-time communication that you had with Colonel Garma when you relayed such to her?
We did not discuss the details, Mr. Chair.
But you discussed the members of the team. Kaya nga na banggit ni Colonel Garma sa kanyang affidavit, itong members na to.
Yeah, we did not discuss. Perhaps he took it from other source, Mr. Chair.
Well, we will have to accept that as your answer, but it should be noted by this committee that these were actually in the affidavit of Colonel Garma. She specifically mentioned in paragraph 22 that Leonardo informed me that he had recalled several trusted personnel. So on the one hand, we have Colonel Leonardo saying that Colonel Garma got this information through other sources. But on the other hand, we have Colonel Garma confirming that it was Leonardo who informed her. But in either case, it is corroborated that these members, these names that were mentioned, were in fact picked by Colonel Leonardo. That's just a manifestation, Mr. Chair, for consideration of the truthfulness and the totality of the affidavit of Ms. Garma. So in addition to that, it was also mentioned here, Colonel Leonardo, in paragraph 23, that you conveyed to her that the task force would be structured differently and that he submitted a document to Bongo detailing the task force's operations, including an overview of the current drug landscape in the Philippines. Mr. Chair, Colonel Leonardo, do you confirm this portion, that you submitted a plan to SAP Bongo? Or at the time, hindi pa po siya SAP, I think.
We did not submit any proposal, Mr. Chair.
So
it was just a plan, Mr. Chair.
Oh, yun. Not a proposal, but there was a plan. And did you submit this? You indeed submitted this plan to the higher authorities?
We weren't able to do so, Mr. Chair, because there was this. There was a plan already for the PNP, Mr. Chair.
The plan for the PNP that existed prior to the assumption of the administration, tama po ba? Because at the time that you had this meeting in June 2016, hindi pa po nakakaupo yung presidente, tama po?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
So at the time that you were crafting the plan, how did you know na hindi matutuloy kung wala pa naman op-plan double barrel?
Meron na pong plano yung sa double barrel, Mr. Chair, prior pag-upo. Bago pa umupo si Senator, then Chief PNP Bato de la Rosa, Mr. Chair.
So, Mr. Chair, Colonel Leonardo, saan po dun yung fit supposedly ng proposed task force ninyo? Kung meron ng operation op-plan double barrel that was already being planned even prior to the assumption of the administration, tapos tinaprin po kayo, and I think this is corroborated because on national TV, the former president, although it would have been ideal for him to confirm it here today, but since he's not here, we'll have to take yung media coverage for its word, no? Nabanggit na it was admitted that you were picked because magaling, he trusted you with money, hindi mo gagalawin yung pera, etc., etc. So it corroborates the fact that you were chosen. And you did admit to being chosen for a planned task force, although you're very specific in saying na plano pa lang po. So how do we now reconcile na? On one hand, meron na palang plano for op-plan double barrel, but on the other hand, tinaprin po kayo to come up with a proposed task force, which in your testimony, nung withdraw naman kasi mas pinili po yung double barrel. How do we reconcile that po kaya, Colonel Leonardo?
Mr. Chair, nung nagpa-plano po kami, bigla na alaman namin na meron na po palang plano para implement ni Chief PNP, Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair, you mentioned nalaman na lang namin?
Nalaman po namin, Mr. Chair. Kasi I was still nasa NCR po ako noon, Mr. Chair. So it was already conceptualized that the PNP will implement Tokhang similar with that of implementation in Davao during the time of Serbato as Davao City police chief, Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chair, sino po kaya yung kasama dyan sa namin? Sino-sino po kayo yung nagpaplano nito na nagulat na nagkaroon ng op-plan double barrel?
Hindi pa po nakakaupo si Chief PNP Bato, Mr. Chair. Meron na po mga nagplano sa hierarchy ng PNP because alam po nila yung model na gusto ni Chief PNP, Mr. Chair.
Okay. Sige po. Mr. Chair, to simplify na lang po, Colonel Leonardo, can you explain to us what were the operational or structural highlights po nung proposed task force po ninyo? Kasi po, sa affidavit ni Ms. Garma, Colonel Garma, sorry, may specifics naman po dito kung sino po yung members ninyo, paano po yung financials, paano po yung operations, to an extent. Pero you now mentioned that there was a task force and you admitted to some of the points of Colonel Garma.